Hallelujah, name is Christ. We commence afternoon session.
耶稣圣名开始下午的聚会.
So we continue to study Joshua, the son of a sprouting seed.
那么继续学习约书亚，发芽种子的儿子.
We know that the Israelites spent 40 years in the wilderness.
我们知道以色列人在旷野过了40年.
And those who can fight in a battle, there were like 400,000 of them.
之后大概有
And only two that were able to enter the promised land.
但是只有两个人可以进入应许之地.
That was Joshua and Caleb.
是约书亚还有迦勒.
So when we look at the characteristic of Joshua,
对，我们如果看约书亚的性格,
we can see they keep mentioning that Joshua, he was the son of Nun.
可以发现圣经一直重复地说约书亚是嫩的儿子。
And then if we look at what it means to be the son of Nun, it means that the son of Nun is the son of a sprouting seed.
嫩的儿子的意思就是发芽种子的儿子的意思。
Because sprouting seed, that means there's life.
因为种子在发芽代表它有生命。
Sprouting seed, this means there's such great potential to grow, to be something become so wonderful.
在发芽的种子就有潜力可以长成一个很美好的东西。
And a sprouting seed also, you know, represent that he is the offspring of something great.
发芽的种子也可以说是一个好的后代。
So the same thing for us.
所以对我们也是一样。
We also are sons and daughters of sprouting seed.
我们也是这个发芽种子的儿女。
Actually, that sprouting seed is our Lord Jesus Christ.
事实上这个发芽种子就是耶稣。
Because through him that you and I once again, we have eternal life.
因为藉由他我们又再一次的拥有永生。
And once again that you and I can have peace, can have hope, we can have joy in this world.
那我们在这个世界上可以有和平，还有盼望，还有喜乐。
But of course, for this sprouting seed to continue to grow, we must, you know, practice and follow what Joshua did.
如果我们想要成为这样这个撒种的种，发芽的种子， 我们就要学习约书亚。
And we know that Joshua chapter 8 verse 31, verse 30 and verse 31.
在约书亚记8章的30到31节。
That Joshua, he was a son, but he was a seed to put God first.
他是一个种子，是随时都把神放在前第一的。
And then we also say that in chapters 5 in Joshua,
那在约书亚记的第5章,
verse 13 and 14,
13、14节,
he's also a seed that truly worship God.
他是很真诚来敬畏神的，敬拜神的。
Then when we go to Exodus chapter 33,
再翻到出埃及记的33章,
verse 11,
11节,
he is a seed of cultivation.
他是一个会自己灵修的种子。
So even though Moses, you know, he spoke to God face to face.
因为摩西可以跟神面对面的说话。
And Moses left, you know, the tabernacle.
那摩西离开了会幕。
But Joshua, the son of Nun, even though he was young, but he remained and did not depart from the tabernacle.
那当时还很年轻的约书亚, 他却留在了会幕。
Of course, for a young man, you know, to have that kind of characteristic is something for us to admire.
一个年轻人拥有这样的特质是值得我们敬佩的。
Then in Joshua chapter 10,
在约书亚记10章,
verse 12 and verse 13,
12到13节,
we say that he's a seed of prayer.
他是一个会祷告的种子。
We can see that when he prayed, God listened to his prayer.
当他祷告的时候，神会垂听他的祷告。
Because he wanted the sun to stood still and the moon to stop, then that's what God did for him.
因为他想要让日月停下来, 那神就听了他的祷告。
So his prayer is not only, you know, not only God listened, but his prayer is very powerful.
那他的祷告不, 神不止垂听, 还非常的有能力。
And Joshua, book of Joshua chapter 7,
那约书亚记的第7章,
we know verse 6 to verse 9, we say that he also a seed that truly glorified God's name.
这个约书亚也是一个会荣耀神的种子。
Now let's go to verse 9.
到第9章,
I think this is what we concluded the last time.
这是我们上次的总结。
Joshua chapter 7, verse 9.
约书亚记的第7章第9节。
For the Canaanites and all the inhabitants of the land will hear it and surround us and cut off our name from the earth. Then what will you do for your great name?
迦南人和这一切的居民听见了，就必围困我们，将你们的民从地上除灭。那时你为你的大名要怎样行呢？
Joshua, he realized that if the Israelites are cut off by the enemies, then God's name would not be glorified.
约书亚知道，如果以色列人被除灭，那他神的名就不无法得到荣耀。
So when you and I pray to God,
所以当我们跟神祷告的时候，
we must have this mentality that no matter what we do, we must glorify His name.
我们 要有这样的心态，无论我们做什么都要荣耀他的名。
You know, sometimes for us as Christians, you know, when we go out there in public or go out there in the world, not only we do not glorify God's name, but we defame God's name.
常常我们在世界上，我们不止没有荣耀神，反而让他的名得到让他的名污名化。
It's funny because, you know, my wife, she opened a restaurant almost 3 years now.
我的太太开的餐厅大概已经有三年了。
And every time we deal with certain people, and the minute they say, oh, we are Christian too.
那常常他会跟一些人在处理一些事情的时候，他们会说他们也是基督徒。
And the minute they say that, there's a red flag that come up, right?
那有时候他们这样一说就会看到一个警戒的标志。
Because thus far, most of the Christians we deal with, actually, we cannot trust them. You know, we cannot trust them.
因为有时候我们跟这些基督徒来处事的时候，我们是没有办法相信他们。
Of course, there's so many great Christians out there.
当然有很多很好的基督徒。
I'm just giving an example of, you know, dealing with business and things like that.
那我所给的例子是当在做生意的时候。
But that is very sad. Why? Because, you know, if we truly believe in the same God.
这让人难过。为什么？因为如果我们相信的是同一个
神。And whatever you and I do, we must glorify the name of God.
那我们所做的，我们都要来荣耀神。
So now would we should not deceive people or lie to people, any of these things.
所以你不应该去欺骗别人。
Even though we want to do business and things like that.
虽然我们想要做生意。
Now let's go Exodus chapter 17.
那我们翻到出埃及记的十七章。
Joshua, he also a son of courage.
那约书亚也是一个会鼓励人的人。
Actually, he's very courageous throughout his whole life.
他很勇敢，因为他很勇敢的出去打仗。
And that something is so hard to find, right? When you look at in the Bible for him.For 80 years, right? We do not know what he did for the first 40 years. But we know, you know, as he continued his journey and entered the promised land, he continually to be courageous.
虽然我们不知道约书亚的早年是怎么过，但是我们知道他之后一样很勇敢的征战，直到进入应许之地。
And verse 8.
那第八节。
Exodus chapter 7, verse 8. Exodus chapter 17, verse 8.
出埃及记十七章的第八节。
Now Amalek came and fought with Israel in Rephidim, verse 9.
九节。
And Moses said to Joshua, Choose us some men and go out. Fight with Amalek tomorrow. I will stand on the top of the hill with the rod of God in my hand, verse 10.
十节。
So Joshua did as Moses said to him and fought with Amalek. And Moses, Aaron, and Hur went up to the top of the hill. So we can see in these three verses, this is a time that Joshua was a young man.
所以我们可以看到这三节，那约书亚当时是一个年轻人。
And we know that Amalekites actually they formed the descendant of Esau.
那亚玛利人是以扫的后代。
And we know that Esau he's a man, you know, he's a hunter, right? So his descendant are very powerful, they're very strong.
那以扫是一个猎人，所以他的后代是非常有能力、非常强壮。
But of course, when you talk about the Amalekites, talk about they're all about their fleshly desire.
但是我们讲到亚玛利人，就会讲到他们肉体上的情欲。
So during this time, without anyone provoking them, they came up against the children of God.
所以他们就来跟以色列人来征战。
And they fought against them.
他跟以色列人来征战。
Even though Joshua was a young man,
虽然约书亚是一个年轻人
，but Moses trusted completely in this young man to fight the battle.Not to destroy the Amalekites.
那摩西完全的相信信任这约书亚，让他来跟亚玛利人打仗。
And this is something that you and I can see in the characteristic of Joshua also.
那这里我们也可以看到约书亚的一个特质。
That other people can truly rely on him.
别人能够真的去依赖这个人。
To fulfill whatever purpose that you know they want him to fulfill.
去完成他们想要让。
If you read the book of Joshua later on, we can see that, right? When Moses commanded Joshua, you know, to write all the words of the law and to do this, do that, even the, you know, way late after Moses' death, Joshua still remembered what Moses said.
所以我们如果继续读约书亚记，就算摩西死后，约书亚还是记得摩西说的话。
So here, that's why Moses had no problem. Joshua, go pick up some men, right, and go and fight against the Amalekites.
所以这里摩西就叫约书亚去选一些人来跟亚玛利人征战。
So you will do your part, and we will do our part.
做你的事情，我们会尽我们的本分。
Because tomorrow we will go on top of the hill, and the three of us will pray for the situation.
因为明天我们三人会上到山上为这场战争来祷告。
And look at verse 10.
再看第十节。
So Joshua did as Moses said to him.
所以约书亚照着摩西对他说的话行。
We also can see the saying that Joshua did what Moses said to him, or Joshua did what God said to him, is very frequent, right? Joshua, he was very, you know, reliable, right? For not only in front of Moses, but also in front of God.
那我们常常看到约书亚照着摩西的话行，或者照神的话行，代表他是一个很值得依靠的人。
I mean, if we look at a young generation nowadays,
如果我们看现在比较年轻的一代
，What are the sins that truly overcome them?
那罪是胜过他们的。
I see there's fleshly sin, right? Fleshly sin
是肉体上的罪。
But for Joshua, he was not afraid to fight against Amalekites.
但是在约书亚并不会去惧怕来跟亚玛利人征战。
So that's why for our older generation, we really need to pray for the younger people.
所以对老一代的我们来说，要为这些年轻一代的人来祷告。
Just like Moses, Aaron, and Hur pray for Joshua to destroy the enemy, the Amalekites.
就像摩西、亚伦跟户珥一样，为约书亚他们来祷告，来跟亚玛利人征战。
And we know that every time Moses' hand dropped, Joshua would be losing the battle.
直到每一次摩西的手降下来的时候，约书亚就开始战败。
But when Aaron and Hur helped and lift up his hands, then Joshua prevailed over his enemy.
那当亚伦跟户珥把摩西的手举起来的时候，约书亚就战胜。
Even though Joshua is very courageous,
虽然说约书亚是非常勇敢
，but he still need the help from Moses, Aaron, and Hur.
但是他还是需要摩西亚伦跟户珥的帮忙。
Just like many young generation, they are very courageous.
就像现在年轻一代，他们是非常的勇猛。
But every day they fight against their fleshy desire.
他们每一天都要跟肉体的欲望来征战。
And we really need to pray for them.
我们非常需要来帮他们祷告。
Right, as the older generation, why? Because there will be the new pillars, right? The new leaders in church.
那我们。老一辈的一定 要真的要来帮他们祷告，因为他们是未来教会的柱石。
What happened if Joshua died during this battle?
那如果约书亚在这场战争当中死了
，Then who gonna lead the Israelites when Moses died into the Promised Land?
那谁可以来领导以色列人进入迦南地呢
？Actually, maybe Caleb.
有可能是加勒。
But we don't see in many others.
但是我们看不到其他的人。
But whatever it is, the young generation.They truly need our prayers.
那不管怎样，那年轻的一代真的需要我们的代祷。
Because Satan is truly using right the social media to fulfill their fleshy desire, and if they live that kind of life, there's no way they can lead right in the future.
魔鬼是用这些社交媒体来让这些年轻一代充满了一些情欲。那如果他们继续这样生活，他们就无法在未来可以领导。
So that's why do not forget to pray for them.
所以不要忘记为他们来祷告。
There's many Joshuas out there.
那其实有很多约书亚。
Let's pray for them so they can prevail over the enemies.
我为他们祷告，让他们能够胜过仇敌。
So that in the future they can lead God's people.
在将来他们可以带领神属神的百姓。
Joshua also was a seed of obedient.
约书亚是一颗顺服的种子。
You know,Joshua, he was a great leader. He was a great follower. But at the same time, he was so obedient to everything that God wanted him to do.
约书亚是一个带领者，也同时也是一个跟从者。但是他也非常顺服神所要他做的事情。
Let's go to Joshua chapter 6.
再翻到约书亚记第六章。
This may be, you know, 40 years later, right? After he fought against the Amalekites. This is about 40 years later.
这大概是在约书亚跟亚玛利人征战40年以后。
Because as they go through the, you know, enter the promised land, there's a great city before them, that is the city of Jericho.
当他们要进入迦南地的时候，路上有一座很雄伟的大城，叫做耶利哥。
No, when I read, you know, this verse 1 to verse 5,
当我读六章一到五节的时候，
and I just think about if I was Joshua,
就想说如果我是约书亚的话，
what would be my response to God?
那我会怎么样回应神呢？
But Joshua did not say one word.
但是约书亚没有说任何一句话。
Even though God gave him this, you know, the way to destroy the city of Jericho is so unorthodox, right? It's so strange, it's so weird, right? But he didn't say anything.
就算神所下的指令是非常奇怪，但是约书亚还是没有说任何一句话。
If we read the history of Jericho, Jericho is the strongest city during the time, because the word Jericho means, you know, a great fortified city.
如我们读耶利哥的历史，但那时候它是最坚固的城，因为耶利哥就是这个意思。
Let's go to verse one.
我们读第一节。
Joshua chapter 6 verse 1.
约书亚记六章第一节。
Now Jericho was securely shut up.Because of the children of Israel, none went out and none came in. Verse 2.
第二节。
And the Lord said to Joshua, See, I have given Jericho into your hand, its king and the mighty men of valor. Verse 3.
三节。
You shall march around the city, all your men of war. You shall go all around the city once. This you shall do 6 days. Verse 4.
四节。
And 7 priests shall bear 7 trumpets,of ram's horns before the ark. But the 7th day you shall march around the city 7 times, and the priest shall blow the trumpets. Verse 5.
Yeah.
It shall come to pass when they make a long blast with the ram's horn, and when you hear the sound of the trumpet, that all the people shall shout with a great shout. Then the wall of the city will fall down flat, and the people shall go up, every man straight before him.It is a very strange way to destroy this great city of Jericho.
是一个很奇怪的方法来击败这耶利哥城。
But this is only one example how Joshua was so obedient, not only you know, to God, but also to Moses' words.
那这是其中一个约书亚很顺服神和摩西的话的一个例子。
But here God told him, look, I will give you, right? I'm giving you Jericho into your hand.Its king and also the mighty man of valor.
这里神对约书亚说：“我将耶利哥的王和大并大能的勇士都交在他的手中。”
Remember, Joshua, he's a man of war, right? He's a man of valor since he's a young, you know, since he's a young man.
记得约书亚从小就是一个勇，就是一个战士了。
And I'm sure, you know, if he say go and fight, he's ready to fight.
如果叫他去打仗，他一定准备好要去打仗。
And that's why before they destroyed the city of Jericho, the commander of God, right, was standing, you know, beside him or opposite of him. He was not afraid. He went straight forward and talked to him.
所以在他们要去打耶利哥城的时候，神的使者站在他旁边，那他并不会惧怕，直接上去跟他讲话。
We see that Joshua was very courageous.
可以看到约书亚是很勇敢的。
But here, the way God gave him instruction to destroy the city of Jericho, it's really just the opposite how he is as a warrior, as a person.
神所给的指令跟他身为勇士是完全180度的不一样。
God told him the first 6 days, they must march around, right, the city of Jericho one time each day.
神告诉约书亚说前六天他们要绕耶利哥城一圈。
But on the 7th day, and then they must march 7 times.
那第七天他们要绕城七次。
Then after they do that, they're going to blow, you know, the trumpets, blow the trumpet, and then the city will fall down flat.
接下来祭司们要吹号、吹角，那耶利哥城墙就会倒塌。
Really put ourselves in Joshua's shoes.
如果我们把自己用约书亚的立场来想
，No, a great warrior been fighting for 40 years.
大能勇士已经征战40年了。
He must have some kind of self pride inside of him. You know, he's like, you know, no. Why do you tell me to do this? Just let me us go in, right, and destroy the city.
他心中应该有身为勇士的骄傲，他可能会想说，就让我们进去征战吧。
Because we can see, actually, when they prepared to destroy the city of Jericho, they had many warriors, right? They had soldiers ready to conquer already.That was, you know, Joshua before God spoke to him.
所以我们可以看到在神跟约书亚 说话之前已经有很多勇士准备好要上去攻城了。
And how come Joshua truly knew that this word is from God himself?
那约书亚是怎么知道这是从神来的话呢？
Remember, he's a man of cultivation. He's a man of, you know, he's a man of prayer. Of course, his relationship with God was great.
他是一个会修自己并且会祷告的人，所以他知道。
And he knew this instruction, even as strange as it was, but it's from God.
虽然这个指令是非常的奇怪，但是它的确是从神而来的。
So that's why for us, if we really close to God,
所以如果我们跟神非常亲近
，to be obedient to His word, it would not take much.
要顺服他的话是很就比较容易。
If you and I can hear the voice of God very clearly, you and I would never say no to anything that He wants us to do.
如果我们可以很清楚听到神的话，那我们就不会对他要我们做的事情说不。
The problem is that when you and I cannot hear God's voice very clearly.
那问题就在于，如果我们没有办法很清楚的听到神的话
，then we cannot understand His will very clearly.
我们就没有办法了解神的意思。
Then we would not know exactly what we need to do to destroy, especially certain things in our lives.
就不知道如何来把我们生活上一些该摧毁的东西摧毁。
Or to conquer certain things that God wants us to conquer.
或者是战胜一些神要我们战胜的东西。
We know that obedience, you know, is so important.
顺服是非常重要的。
Why did sin enter the world?
为什么罪进入世界呢？
Because of Adam and Eve disobedient.
因为亚当夏娃他们不顺服。
And why did King Saul and his descendant were destroyed? Because of his disobedience.
为什么扫罗跟他的后代被除灭了呢？因为扫罗不顺服。
And why Achan and his family also were destroyed because of their disobedience?
为什么亚干跟他的家人被除灭了呢？因为亚干他们不顺服。
So that's why for us we cannot afford to be disobedient.
所以我们不能够不顺服。
Whatever you and I have been taught in the Bible, you know, from you know for years and years, we must continue to follow it and practice it.
从圣经上所学到的，我们必须要真的去顺服，并且实行出来。
And be obedient to every single word that God wants us to do.
也要对神对我们所说的每一句话、每一个字也是要顺服的。
And only then, the sprouting seed will continue to grow strong.
这个发芽的种子就会继续成长茁壮。
Now let's go to Joshua chapter 4.
再翻到约书亚记的第四章
，verse 14,
十四节。
Joshua chapter 4, verse 14.
约书亚记四章十四节。
You know, throughout the whole journey in the wilderness,
在以色列人在旷野的人。
And we know, we see very clear that Joshua was such a humble person.
可以看到约书亚是很谦卑的。
But maybe during that time, because Moses was a leader, that's why he just feel, you know, he's nothing compared to Moses.
那当然有可能是因为当时摩西是一个是领导者，那约书亚可能觉得自己跟他比起来什么都不是。
But remember, after Moses' death,
但是我们要记得，在摩西死后
，He and Joshua chapter 4 verse 14,
在四章十四节说
，On that day, the Lord exalted Joshua in the sight of all Israel, and they feared him as they had feared Moses all the days of his life.
当那日，主使约书亚在以色列众人眼前尊大。在他平生的日子，百姓敬畏他，像从前敬畏摩西一样。
Actually, by this time, Joshua's resume is great.
在这个时候，约书亚显现他的伟大。
And God Himself exalted Joshua in front of all the elders, in front of all Israel.
啊，神使约书亚在以色列百姓面前尊大。
No, he could have been, you know, very proud.
他可能会很骄傲。
But actually, because he has a seed of humility.
那是因为他心中有谦卑的种子。
It doesn't matter how much God exalted him, he continued to be humble.
对，不管他的地位多么的大，他持续的谦卑。
And this is something, you know, that is something so great that you and I should really study his character.
对，我们必须要详细的、仔细的来学习约书亚的品格。
If you look at the quality or the characteristic of Joshua, every great quality he had is to the extreme. It's something so amazing. It's hard, you know, to follow.
可以看到约书亚的任何好的特质都是 非常非常的好，这是很难 去学习的，
well,
学习到的。
Think about the 40 years in the wilderness.
那我们看第四，他在旷野的四十年。
Did we read anything even one time that he was not full of humility?
我们有读到任何一次他不谦卑吗？
Then when God chose him to lead the Israelites into the promised land and divide the land to all different tribes, did we read anything that he was not full of humility?
当约书亚带领以色列百姓进入迦南，并且为十二支派分地，我们有看读到说约书亚是不谦卑的吗？
Actually, we cannot.
其实我们找不到这样。
And that's why he was the right person for God, to ask to lead the chosen people.Into the promised land.
对，他是对的人，让神来指派他带领以色列人进入埃及，然后进入迦南地。
If you and I want to be that sprouting seed,
如果我们想要成为这个发芽的种子，
we must realize we should be full of humility.
我们要知道，我们要充满谦卑的心。
Actually, if you see a sprouting seed, even though it has such potential to grow, but at the same time it's very fragile.
那我们看到一个发芽的种子，虽然它很有潜力，可以长很大，但是它非常的脆弱。
You and I can just go and, pluck it out, or we can step on it, right? This and that, and it'd be dead right away.
我们可以去把它拔出来，甚至踩到它上面，那它就会死掉了。
And so for us, it doesn't matter how much potential we have and how much we have. We always remember, in the eyes of the Lord, we are nothing.
所以不管我们拥有多少，我们的潜力有多大，在神眼中我们都是很渺小。
And the humility that we have inside our heart should be forever.
那我们心中的谦卑需要永远的存在。
No matter what kind of situation you and I are in.
不管我们在怎样的状况之下。
As long as you and I have humility, God will continue to exalt us.
只要有我们心中有谦卑，神就会持续不断的提升我们。
You know, earlier, and all the brothers just talking how educated a lot of members are.
那之前我在跟弟兄谈论说，现在的人是多么受到教育。
Really, we have a lot of members who they're PhDs, or doctors, engineering, but when you talk to them, you can never tell.
有些人他们虽然有博士学位，但是在跟他们聊天的时候是没有办法发现的。
And this is really one of the great characteristics that we can find in our church.
这也是我们可以在这间教会找到的一个好的特质。
Nobody ever boasts what college they go to or what kind of degrees they have. Nobody ever boasts this kind of stuff.
不会去夸耀说我们去了多好的大学。
And this is something that is so wonderful in the eyes of the Lord.
在神眼中是很美好的。
And the reason why we can manifest a kind of characteristic becausewe are the sons of the sprouting seed.
那我们为什么可以来显现出这么好的特质？因为我们是发芽种子的儿子。
And we hope and pray that you and I continue to be like this.
希望我们期望也一起祷告，希望我们大家都可以继续保持。
As long as you and I have a heart of humility, God will continue to exalt us and also our church.
只要我们有谦卑的心，神就会提升我们以及我们的教会。
Now let's go to the next one.
那我们要去再看下一个。
And one thing that you and I realize about Joshua, he also have such great faith.
另外一点，约书亚他拥有非常
since he was a young man,
他的信心很有很大的信心。
And he
从小
brought his faith also into the promised land.
他把这个信心一起带入到应许之地。
Let's go to Numbers chapter 14.
看民数记十四章。
Joshua, he is the seed of faith.
约书亚是一个信心的种子。
Verse 6.
第六节。
Numbers chapter 14, verse 6.
民数记十四章第六节。
But Joshua the son of Nun and Caleb the son of Jephunneh, who were among those who had spied out the land, tore their clothes.
六节，窥探地的人中，嫩的儿子约书亚和耶弗尼的儿子加勒撕裂衣服。
Remember, Joshua and Caleb, they are the two of the spies that went to spy the land of Canaan.
约书亚跟加勒是十二个探子去窥探迦南地十二个探子当中的两个。
The other ten tribes came give bad report.
其他十个探子回来都是报坏消息。
So when Joshua the son of the sprouting seed heard of it, he tore his clothes.
对，当约书亚这个发芽种子的儿子听到的时候，他就撕裂衣服。
Of course, tore his clothes to repent before God.
撕裂衣服就是在神面前要悔改。
Then verse 7.
第七节。
And they spoke to all the congregation of the children of Israel, saying, The land we passed through to spy out is exceedingly good land. Verse 8.
第八节,
if the Lord delights in us, then he will bring us into this land and give it to us, a land which flows with milk and honey. Verse 9.
九节,
only do not rebel against the Lord, nor fear the people of the land, for they are our bread. Their protection has departed from them, and the Lord is with us. Do not fear them. Wow. When we read these verses, we can see the faith that Joshua had.
当我们读这一段经节的时候，我们可以发现约书亚的极大的信心。
No, I love it. In verse 9, you say, you know, they are our bread. Why, they are our bread.
第九节说，他们是我们的食物。
This means we're going to eat them for dinner.
代表说我们要 把他们拿来当晚餐。
Why? Because their protection have departed from them.
为什么呢? 因为把他们的硬币已经离开他们。
Because the Lord is with us.
因为有主与我们同在。
You can see how great faith that he had.
可以看到他是有多大的信心。
Remember the 10 spies, when they report about the land, actually, they were not wrong, right? They report exactly what they saw.
但其他10个探子在报 消息的时候，其实他们并没有说谎，他们是按照他们所看到的讲出来而已。
Yes, they saw the giants in the land.
他们看到的是那个地里面的巨人，
which was true.
是真的。
They saw the chariot of iron, which was true.
他们看到
chariot of iron, yeah, their chariot is very strong, right?
他们的战车非常的强壮。
And they see all these people, they are not only giants, they are mighty warrior.
那这些人他们 不但高大, 他们还很勇猛。
What we're saying, what they're saying, they didn't lie. They saw exactly what they see with their eyes.
他们所说的并没有错, 他们真的看到了。
But what Joshua saw was from the eyes of God.
约书亚是用神的眼光来看事情。
If God delight in us,
如果神喜悦我们,
he will bring us into this land.
他会把我们带进这个地。
If God is with us,
如果神与我们同在,
then these people is nothing, you know, there's nothing in front of us.
然后在我们面前是不算什么的。
We can eat them, we can eat them up, and we can destroy them.
可以吃他们，把他们打倒。
But during the time, look at verse 10.
看第十节。
But and all, right? Not some, all the congregation say to stone them with stones.
但是全会众说拿石头打死他们两人。
Like this. Imagine if you and I were one of the person in the congregation.
如果我们是在会众其中的一人,
and when we heard this, we want to stone him to death.
我们听到这他们所说的, 就想要用石头打他们。
And this is a man with such great faith, right?
这个人是非常有信心的。
And because of this, and that's why the second half, verse 10, now the glory of the Lord appeared in the tabernacle of meeting before all the children of Israel.
对,十节后半段说, 忽然主的荣光在会幕中向以色列众人显现。
Of course, if God had not appeared in a time, Joshua and Caleb would have been dead.
当然,如果神那时候没有显现, 约书亚跟加勒可能就死了。
So what does this mean for us?
这是什么意思呢?
Of course, you and I must have great faith.
当然,我们要有大的信心。
But having great faith, we also must have great compassion to those who do not have faith.
但是,就算我们有信心, 我们也要 对那些没有信心的人有一个同理心。
We know our spirituality is always ups and we have our doubts.
因为灵性总是会有高跟低。
And some of us are more, you know, spiritual than others.
有些人是比其他人更属灵。
But nevertheless, we still family.
不管如何,我们都是家人。
Is we must continue to help one another to enter the promised land.
彼此帮助进入这个应许之地。
No, Joshua and Caleb can just go their ways, right? They're like, you guys are lack of faith. You guys don't want to enter the promised land. You know what? Caleb and I, our tribe, we're going to go.
约书亚跟加勒可能会说，这些小信的人，那你们就继续待在那，那我们的支派要进去。
But he didn't say that. He didn't do that.
他并没有这样说。
Because knowing that they are the, you know, they all are God's children.
因为他知道这些人都是神的子民。
Instead, Joshua suffered 40 years for those who lack of faith.
但是反而约书亚跟这些不信的人在旷野受苦40年。
And that's a long, right? That suffering was really long.
这个苦难是非常的长久的。
But that's not only, you know, when he says suffering, of course, they want to stone him and Moses many times, like throughout the wilderness.
其实百姓也在旷野中也想要用石头打摩西 好几次。
If you and I read about Joshua and Moses, actually they fall flat in their face many times because they're chosen people, right? Continue to sin against God.
我们可以看到摩西跟约书亚他们好几次脸伏伏在地，在众会众前面，因为他们持续不断的犯罪。
So for those of us who have great faith,
所以我们有信心、有大信心的人
，we must help our brother and sister who do not have great faith.
必须要来帮助那些没有的。
We should not, you know, of course, we must speak the truth in love. We must continually, you know, carry one another, so every single one of us can enter the promised land.
我们要彼此的彼此关怀，让每一个人都可以进入到应许之地。
Even though the congregation, you know, want to stone him to death.
就算全会众都想要把他用石头把他们打死。
But Joshua's faith never, you know, languished, you know, this, never fade away in his whole life.
但是约书亚的信心并没有因此而减少。
Now let's go to Joshua chapter 8.
再翻到约书亚记的第八章。
Joshua also was a seed that truly shared the word of God with others.
约书亚也是一颗会把神的话传播给大家的人种子。
Chapter 8 verse 34.
约书亚记的八章三十四节。34节。
And afterward he read all the words of the law, the blessing and the cursings, according to all that is written in the book of the law.
三十四节，随后约书亚将律法上祝福咒诅的话，照着律法书上一切所写的都宣读了一遍。
You know, in the middle of all this battle, and you know, they just entered the promised land, destroying city of Jericho, destroying Ai, but Joshua took the time to share the word of God with all the chosen people.
在这些战争当中，他们刚消灭了耶利哥，消灭了爱城。约书亚用这个时间来把神的话给宣读给众百姓听。
And he was not biased.
他也没有偏见。
He shared the word of blessings. He also shared the word of cursing.
他把祝福跟咒诅的话都宣读了一遍。
And this is very important.
这很重要。
Because the word of God is blessing, is also cursing.
因为神的话充满着祝福，同时也有诅咒。
Just like nowadays, even though, yes, we want to hear everything, right? It's wonderful, everything is great, isn't that? But God is also just. We must share. If we don't do certain things, you and I will be cursed.
虽然说我们都很想要听到很美好的事物，但是神也是公义的。如果我们没有把这些事情分享出去，那我们就会受到咒诅。
Look at verse 35.
再看35节。
Because we talk about him being so obedient, right?
也讲到约书亚很顺服。
And it said there was not a word of all that Moses had commanded, which Joshua did not read before all the assembly of Israel, with the women, the little ones, and the strangers who were living among them.
摩西所吩咐的一切话，约书亚在以色列全会众和妇女孩子，并他们中间寄居的外人面前，没有一句不宣读的。
Now we know the word of Moses is the word of God.
那摩西的话就是神的话。
If we can see that Joshua say here, right, not a word, right, not a word of all that Moses had commanded, which Joshua did not read before assembly. So he was very faithful, right? He was very diligent.
所以他很勤奋，那他也很。他把所有摩西所说的一切话都宣读给众人。
And he wanted to share all this word with the congregation.
他想要把这一切的话都跟会众来分享。
Because he knows that all this time, the reason why he can stand strong, the reason why he can be, you know, the sprouting seed, because of the word of God.
那他知道他为什么可以这么的强壮，可以成为一个发芽的种子，都是因为神的话。
So he wanted to share this with the whole congregation.
所以他想要把神的话给分享给众会。
So that's why the same mentality that you and I must have.
这也是我们必须要有的心态。
Whatever God has revealed to us and shared with us, we must share with our brothers and sisters.
主向我们所显现、所吩咐我们的话，我们都要跟弟兄姐妹来分享。
We should not only share things about love, but we also have to share things.About judgment, right? That God will bring upon us.
我们不能只分享爱，我们也要分享最后的审判。
Of course, there's nothing wrong to share about love.
当然，分享爱并没有什么错误。
But if we only share about love every single time, this means we have not known the heart of God.
但是如果你只分享了爱，那每一次都这样的话，那表示我们不了解神。
This means we have not shared everything that God wants us to share with one another.
我们还没有。把神要我们分享所有分享给全会众的全部都分享出来。
And let's go to a last one.
再来，我们到最后一点。
If you have time, right, you know, because I'm speeding up a little bit because there's so much about Joshua, really study his character, and you will definitely get inspired.
那我现在其实有点加快速度，因为时间的关系。但如果有时间的话，你们可以请好好的学习约书亚，我们可以发现很多很好的特
质。He is so strong.
他很强壮。
But he was full of compassion.
但是他也是很有同
怜悯心的。Even though he was a great man of valor.
虽然他是很强有力量。
But he loved his brethren very much.
但是他也很爱他的弟兄。
Even though he's so powerful and God exalted him, but he always treated his brethren with such gentleness and kindness.
虽然是他很有他很。很有能力，神提升他，但是他还是很他还是很，就是他还是帮助他的弟兄姐妹。
And that's why Joshua chapter 24.
所以在约书亚记的二十四章
，He really became the seed of inspiration.
那他是一个很激励的种子。
Verse 14.
十四节。
Joshua chapter 24, verse 14.
约书亚记二十四章十四节。
Now therefore fear the Lord, serve Him in sincerity and in truth.And put away the gods which your fathers served on the other side of the river and in Egypt. Serve the Lord. Verse 15.
15节.
And if it seems evil to you to serve the Lord, choose for yourself this day whom you will serve, whether your gods which your fathers served that were on the other side of the river, or the gods of the Amorites in whose land you dwell. But as for me and my house,will serve the Lord. Verse 16.
16节.
So the people answered and said, Far be it from us that we should forsake the Lord to serve other gods. We can see why Joshua was very straightforward.
可以看到约书亚是很直接。
He said, Fear the Lord and serve Him with sincerity and truth.
要敬畏神，心实意的侍奉他。
Put all the foreign gods away.
把所有其他的神都放在一边。
And these are the gods that your fathers have worshipped, right, in Egypt on the side of the river.
这些神是你们的父亲在埃及在河的另外一边所敬拜的。
Then he said, if it seemed to you that serving God is evil, you know what? Then go serve the idols.
如果你们以侍奉神为不好，今日你们就可以选择所要侍奉的。
But as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord.
至于我和我的家，我们必侍奉神。
I mean,People were so inspired in that time.
百姓当时的百姓非常受到激励。
And that's why they answer, "Far be it from us that we should forsake the Lord to serve other gods."
所以他们就回答说，我们断不敢离弃主去侍奉别神。
You can see, right, the people respect Joshua until the end of his life.
可以看到，众百姓敬畏约书亚，直到他生命的结束。
And he was the seed of inspiration for all the chosen people.
他也是一个很激励人的种子。
Right, with his last breath, he said, "No matter what, my family and I will serve the Lord."
在他最后一口气的时候，他说：“我和我家，我们必定侍奉耶和华。”
And this kind of inspiration that you and I should have nowadays also.
那这也是我们必须要得到的激励。
Because you know we need this kind of inspiration from our brothers and sisters.
因为我们需要这样的激励。
Because if we don't have this kind of inspiration, then how can we encourage one another?
如果没有这样受到激励，我们要如何来勉励彼此呢？
Because one day I will be weak, I need your inspiration.
有一天我可能很软弱，我可能需要你来激励我。
And one day, you know, you will be weak, you need my inspiration.
那有一天可能你比较软弱，那需要我的激励。
If we continue to inspire one another through the Word of God and through our characteristic, then we will become a strong church.
所以如果我们借由神的话彼此激励，那我们就会成为一个强壮的教会。
So Joshua.The son of the sprouting seed.
约书亚，发芽种子的儿子。
And he grew up to be something so great.
他成长为一个很伟大的东西。
You and I also are sons of the sprouting seed.
那我们也是发芽种子的儿子。
We also can grow to be something great.
那我们也会成长成很伟大的。
Grow to the point that all of us can enter the heavenly kingdom.
直到我们每一个人都可以进入神的国。
May the Lord help us. Now let's bow and pray in silence.
愿神帮助我们，我们一起低头默祷。